Welcome to Pika Master channel. In this video I will show you how to install the Bad DLSS mod with frame generation by PureDrag for Nova Skyrim. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. First, you need to log in via Patreon or simply register using the available methods on the website. Then type PureDrag into the search bar and select it. And then subscribe to a membership on that page. You can also find information about the mod on PureDrag's Patreon page. In the collections section under the Skyrim game, there you will find a post about the latest version of the DLSS mod, which also includes installation instructions. The installation process may vary slightly depending on the version of the mod. Next, I will guide you through the installation step by step based on that guide. Next, I will show you how to join the Discord server where you can download the mod. First, go back to the main Patreon page and click on PureDrag's profile, then go to membership tab. At the bottom of the membership section, you'll find the quick links. Click on open server and you will be redirected to Discord page where you will need to authorize your Discord account. If this method doesn't work and you still can't access PureDrag's Discord server, there's another second option. Go to your Patreon account settings. On the right side, click More, then choose Connected Apps. Find Discord and then you should click Disconnect. And then connect again. After that, authorize your Discord account and you should get access to the server. How to download the DLSS upscaler and custom reshade. First, go to Home tab on Patreon and click Membership. Scroll down and click Open a server. You will be redirected to PureDrag's Discord server where you will see multiple channels on the left side. I recommend checking out the common questions section. It contains answers to frequently asked questions users often run into. Then go to the Skyrim Beta Access channel and choose the version of the mod you need. Each version includes a description and an installation guide, so make sure to read that as well. Now download the Skyrim upscaler DLSS. Also, if you're using Reshade, make sure to download PureDrag's custom Reshade file. After downloading both DLSS mod and custom Reshade, go to the folder where they were saved. Copy these two archives, then go to the folder where your Nova's dashboard is installed. And navigate to Instances, Archive, and if you didn't enable the archive feature in Nova's and don't have this folder, you can place the archives in any convenient location. Then go to ENB and Reshade and paste both archives there. After that, extract custom Reshade archive in this folder. Copy a DXGI file and paste this file with replacement in a stock game folder. But before replacing it, I recommend making a backup of the original file just in case you need to restore it later. Go back to the folder where the Novus dashboard program is located and launch it. Click play. Now in this program, click on install mode and select the archive with PureDocs DLSS upscaler mode. I will name it the same as the archive, so it's easy to know which version is installed. Then click to activate the mod. Next, scroll up the list. And disable the following mods: Upscaler Base Plugin and Skyrim Upscaler. We don't need them because we'll be using the Upscaler from PureDark instead. Find SSJ Display Tweaks in MO2, right-click on it and select Open in Explorer. Then navigate through the folders and open SSJ Display Tweaks in new file. In this file, you need to remove the hashtag in front of the following lines: full screen and borderless. Next, press Ctrl F and search for frame rate limit. Set frame rate limit based on your monitor's refresh rate. For example, divide your refresh rate by 2 and subtract 1. In my case, the refresh rate is 240 Hz, so I would set it to 119. If the frame rate limit doesn't work here, you can also set it through the NVIDIA control panel. Go to the NVIDIA control panel and make sure that VSync is set on specifically for Skyrim. Also, check that hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is enabled in the default graphics settings. Go back to Novus dashboard and launch the game. Now in the game, press the End key and then click the Authenticate button to activate DLSS. If you weren't able to authenticate this mod in game, there's another method. Go to the Common Questions in the Discord server and download the Patreon zip file. Then extract it and run the Patreon file. In your browser, you will need to click Allow to authorize the mod through Patreon. You can also download the license using the provided link. If you see POL 1 in the console, that means you have successfully authenticated. Disable DOF in the Skyrim settings. This is what the mod will look like when you press the End key. If you see this, it means DLSS is working. You are probably asking, how much FPS does DLSS PureDark with frame gain really give? Well, here are two videos to show you the difference.